Welcome to A&M Education College of Creativity and Technology. In this video, we will learn about Victorian parlor toys. Before we learn about these devices, we need to understand the term persistence of vision. Take a series of sequential images and view it one by one. Play it faster. Remove the gaps. Even faster. We see motion. Why is that? Animation works by using an optical illusion. By presenting a sequence of still images in quick enough succession, the viewer interprets them as a continuous moving image. This is the same principle that enables live-action filmmaking and projection to work. Film theorists often refer to this illusion of movement as persistence of vision. The human eye and brain can only process about 12 separate images per second, retaining an image for 1/16th of a second. If a subsequent image is replaced during this time frame, an illusion of continuity is created. Here is a sequence of images played at the rate of 1 frame per 2 seconds, with 1 blank frame in between. We don't see any motion yet, as we lessen the duration of the blank space. There is a slight change of position and get a sense of motion. Let's play in 1 frame per second, 2 frames per second, 4 frames per second. Now we are starting to get a feel of motion, but it is not smooth. 8 frames per second, 12 frames per second, 24 frames per second. The motion looks even smoother. Now that we understood persistence of vision, let's learn about certain devices which use this principle. During Victorian times, people became fascinated by toys that made pictures move. Numerous devices that successfully displayed animated images were introduced well before the advent of motion picture. These devices were used to entertain, amaze, and sometimes even frighten people. The majority of these devices didn't project their images and could only be viewed by one or few persons at a time. They were considered optical toys rather than devices for a large-scale entertainment industry like later animation. Some of those devices are as follows. Thaumatrope. A thaumatrope is an optical toy that was popular in the 19th century. A disc with a picture on each side is attached to two pieces of string. When the strings are twirled quickly between the fingers, the two pictures appear to blend into one due to the persistence of vision. The thaumatrope was invented by a British physician, John Ayrton Paris, in 1825. It's credited with being the first cinematographic device and shows us something interesting about how the eye works. Next, phenakistoscope. The optical toy phenakistoscope was an early animation device that used this persistence of vision principle to create an illusion of motion. It was invented by Joseph Plateau in 1841. The phenakistoscope used a spinning disc attached vertically to a handle. Arrayed around the disc center were a series of drawings showing faces of animation, and a cut through it were a series of equally spaced radial slits. The phenakistoscope consisted of two discs mounted on the same axis. The first disc had slots around the edge and the second contained drawings of succession action drawn around the disc in concentric circles. The phenakistoscope disc spin together in the same direction. When viewed in a mirror through the first disc slots, the picture on the second disc will appear to move. Next, zoetrope. A zoetrope is made up of a cylinder with slits cut vertically in the sides. There is a row of images on inside of the cylinder. The images are sequential. This means the scene in each image follows the scene in the image before it. When a person looks through a zoetrope, they spin it by hand. The viewer looks through the slits. The images rotate quickly inside the cylinder. Because the images are sequential, they appear to be moving. It was invented by a mathematician named William Horner in 1834. The technology was forgotten for many years, but it was rediscovered in 1867. That year, an American, William Lincoln, patented the name zoetrope. Next, praxinoscope. French inventor Charles-Emile Renault developed the praxinoscope in 1876 and patented it in 1877. It is similar to the zoetrope, but instead of the slits in the cylinder, it has 12 rectangular mirrors placed evenly around the center of the cylinder. Each mirror reflects another image of the picture strip placed opposite on the inner wall of the cylinder. When rotating, the praxinoscope shows the sequential images one by one, resulting in fluid animation. The praxinoscope allowed a much clearer view of the moving image compared to the zoetrope. Since the zoetrope images were actually mostly observed by the spaces in between its slits. Apart from these devices, the most common used optical toy used today is the flipbooks. What is a flipbook? A flipbook is a collection of combined pictures intended to be flipped over to give the illusion of movement and create an animated sequence from a simple small book without machine. The first flipbook appeared in 1868 when it was patented by John Barnes Linnet under the name Kinograph. His kinograph was the first form of animation to use a linear sequence of images like a booklet. A simple flipbook works on the same basic principle that the most advanced movies and videos do. The main difference is that in movies and videos, you're looking at pictures of light that are projected or transmitted onto a screen. And in a flipbook, you're looking at pictures that are printed on little pages of paper. Of course, with the flipbook, you get to hold the movie in your hands and control it yourself. Before there was streaming, the Victorians had magic lanterns. So what is a magic lantern? The magic lantern, also known by its Latin name Lanterna Magica, is an early type of image projector that used pictures, paintings, prints or photographs on a transparent plates, one or more lenses and a light source. It was mostly developed in the 17th century and commonly used for entertainment purposes. It was increasingly used for education during the 19th century. Since the late 19th century, smaller versions were also mass-produced as a toy. The name magic lantern comes from the experience of early audience who saw devils and angels mysteriously appear on the wall as if by magic.